England, 1051. A procession led by Count Eustace II de Boulogne, a close friend of King Edward the Confessor, enters Dover. This courteous visit was a result of an almost 30-year-long acquaintance that dates back to the king's exile to Normandy. Eustace's cottage was safeguarded by a famous fencer, Wilburg of Normandy. Many believed he was Edward's out-of-wedlock son. The gossip burgeoned, chiefly due to the king's habit of booking the Kirk for his repentful prostration. Thus, in the corridors, Edward was criticized for spending most of his time in church, not in the royal bedroom, favoring prayer over dalliance. It was Count de Boulogne whose name was made with debauchery, and his manifestation was nothing short of a bad omen for British people.
Ah, finally Dover. I traveled entire Europe, but never saw such pretty courtesans. I won't be surprised if we don't get any sleep tonight.
My duty is to keep you safe. So, I don't plan to get much sleep for sure.
Oh, Wilburg. Whoever your parents were, they should have just sent you to a monastery rather than an army.
I will be glad to talk this over. But why don't we find a place to rest first?
I know a great tavern here. They should have a room for us.
Wessex seems rather busy these days, with lots of wealthy merchants traveling through here.
This place looks expensive indeed. Still, I am sure we can find a room around. Let me do the talking.
Go, fast! Stop! Who's coming at this ungodly hour?
Open the gate! We are nobles! I don't talk to villagers!
Be gone! Dover is closed for trespassers at night time.
Let's try the other gate.
The king is actually quite concerned with the prosperity of Wessex, you know. Oh, folks here are very rich. Take Godwin, the Earl of Wessex, for example. He is almost as powerful as the king himself. Guts tell me it won't last long.
Go, fast!
What was that? They were waiting for us.
Probably some hungry peasants, looking for someone to rob.
I will talk this time.
Who's there? Sneaking about at night?
We are travelers, looking for a place to lay our heads. It is swarming with bandits here.
It is indeed. Get in and let me have a closer look at you.
You there! Find a tavern and tell them Eustace de Boulogne needs a room. Oh, and bring us two courtesans on the way back. Your daughters will do as well.
Daughters? A boy like you should sleep in a pigsty!
What did you say?
Dogs! Alarm! Get them!
They are after us! Wait! They will lose!
You should have
have to get through Dover. King's men are stationed just outside the gate, on the other side. It's raining! Great. Now the archers will have a hard time reaching us. Find another way.
Thank you. They keep chasing us! Run, fools! The King's men have a camp nearby. Let's find them. Let's go. Warriors, we have been attacked by Godwin's men.
Let's not get reckless, though. The enemy's bound to find our base sooner or later and attack it.
They're coming!
They're attacking us!
Attack!
They are attacking!
We made it. We are safe.
Our king must find out about this immediately.
Eustace II and Wilburg demanded a judgment on the assailants, with retribution in mind. Edward the Confessor's decision was hasty, and he demanded chastisement. Demand was the only thing he could do. After all, the punishment on the subject can only be followed by their liege. And in this case, that happened to be me. I refused to reciprocate, telling the king that they were in their right to defend their families against Eustace's pitiful behavior. Of course, in my speech, I omitted the information that the attack was executed on my command. With his decision undermined, Edward's only choice was to face his strongest lord. That is me, Godwin of Kent. To do so, he had to gather many more forces than he already had.